Okay, so today we'll see what future worth comparison is. So future worth comparison is nothing but finding the future worth of whatever assets we have. So till now we learned present worth. But why do we need future worth? Future worth comparison, we actually in the module 1, we learned that from present worth, we will be able to identify future worth, or from future worth, we will be able to calculate present worth. So that means this both can be translated from present worth to future worth, or from future worth to present worth. Okay, so in certain cases, so where do we use future worth? Future worth we will use if we need to identify, say, what are the effects of inflation in future, what will be the worth of the asset that we have, or if we need to perform certain escalation, then do we need to perform that or not in future? So for that we need to identify the future worth. That is why we go for the calculation of future worth. So I hope you remember, future worth is if we have present worth given, then present worth into F given P. P is the principal amount at that particular point of time, comma I, comma n. What is n? N is the total number of period. So that is what is future worth if we are given present worth at that particular point of time. Okay, so present worth is the current amount that we have. Now what if we are given annuity, that is disbursements for some particular period of time? Again, in the same case, we have a formula to calculate future worth, that is future worth is calculated as, okay, F given A. What is F given A? Future worth given annuity, comma I, comma n, for sorry, capital N. So this is future worth for annuity or disbursements. That is, we are receiving, or we are paying some amount of money every year. Then in that case, it will be F given A comma I comma n. Then we will get future worth for future worth given annuity. Okay, so now coming to the next part, so what do we do here? If as I told, if we want to find out what is the anticipated increase, or what is the effect of inflation that will have in our asset, if we need to find out, then we will go for future worth. Now in order to so in this case there are different scenarios, that is we will see the scenario of bond or stock. So we'll be looking into that. In order to see that, first we need to learn certain terminologies here. That is, first is value. So what do you mean by value? Value is the measure of worth of something, or what is the worth of some asset. That is what value is. Value can be in terms of money. In general, in our economy, we consider value as the amount associated with that asset in order to acquire it. If we need in olden days, in barter system, it was in terms of goods. So that is what it is. So in a transaction process, we always take value of an asset in order to do any transaction. Now, next term is going value. So what is going value? Going value is the assets, how much assets an organization are worth as an operating unit. That is the worth of assets in an organization. Now next is liquidating value. Okay, liquidating value is nothing but if we sell the assets separately from the organization, then what is the total or what is the amount that we will get if we sell the assets separately from the organization. So going value is the overall value of the assets of the organization as a single operating unit, whereas liquidating value we will estimate based on the value of the assets individually or when it is sold separately. That is what is liquidating value. Okay. In general, going value is always greater than liquidating value since the overall organization value will be there. So it will always be great. Next is goodwill. So the difference, next is goodwill. So what is goodwill? Goodwill is the difference between liquidating value and going value. Next is book value. So what do you mean by book value? Book value is worth of an asset for accounting purpose. So whereas market value, next is market value. Market value is the price at which an asset can be sold. So the difference is book value means it can be historical. From the time an asset is acquired to maybe the price can increase in terms of any painting or anything, the book value will keep on increasing, and market value will be at the time an asset is sold what is the value it receives, whereas book value will be and for accounting purpose. So the historical value will be there in the there as the book value. That means from the time if a painting is there, from the time the painting was put in the market, from that time what is the price? Maybe after 10 years what is the price? Now after 20 years what is the price? Also all these historical values will be there as book value, whereas market value will be the price at which an asset can be sold. So this is what these are the different terminologies that we should remember. Next, coming to the next part, we need to learn about bond valuation. So what do you mean by bond? Bond is nothing but if an organization or any service provider needs to raise some money, then they will issue bonds. It is nothing but a debt to the bondholders. It doesn't represent any sort of ownership to the organization. It is ownership. No ownership, but it is a debt to the bondholders. That is, the organization should pay so much amount what the bond promises to the bondholder. That's it. Bond will be issued in order to raise money for the organization. That's it. So in general, this till now we saw interest being calculated annually in all these cases. When we were calculating present worth, we were seeing interest calculated annually. But in case of bond, in general, interest is calculated semi-annually, and at any particular date, maturity date, only it is redeemable. That is how it is. Then each bond will have redemption.